the gentleman, No-Hare Bear and Friends. Friends of air,
to help you get started, to give you a push on your way.
Friends of air,
to turn you around, get your feet on the ground for a brand new day.
They'll pick you up when you're down,
help you swallow your pride when something to die. Gotta break our bridge to the other side.
Friends are someone you can open up to
when you feel like ready to flip.
When you've got the world on your shoulders,
friends are there to give you a tip.
Friends are there when you need them. They're even there when you don't.
For a walk in the park or a shot in the dark, friends are there.
I don't care.
But friends will care for you. No-Hare Bear and Friends.
I'd like to point out to the viewers, no animals were harmed during the making of this program.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the 8th episode of No-Hare Bear and Friends. Well, viewers, I don't know about you. Now, we may have already talked about two video logos and the same video game, but this time we're going to talk about pets. Except pests, obviously. And we've already got one big pest, however, which is No-Hare Bear.
Oi! Who said I was a pest?
I'm just joking, No-Hare Bear.
Oh, alright. Oh, and hello, everybody. I'm here. Well, thank God. How dare you call me a pest?
I'm just joking, No-Hare Bear. Now, anyways, No-Hare Bear, now, today's show is that we're going to be talking about pets.
Pets? Oh. Hang on. Oh, I think I still have my original pet dog named China.
Well, you used to in Georgia with No-Hare Bear, but not anymore, though.
Oh, but I'm sure I still have. And if I... Oh, go and get him now. China, where are you, doggy?
All right, just stop that. I'm Robert.
Well, he'll be coming in a minute, everybody. Don't worry, George. You'll see him again.
All right.
Hello, everybody. I never found here.
Oi, China, what are you doing? You can't do that here. You've got to behave.
Sorry.
Oh, that's all right, China. Oh, anyways, now, do you remember being on Tournament of Hair?
What?
Oh, sir, do you remember being on Tournament of Hair?
What?
I suppose not. Oh, anyways, now, we're into this program. New Hair Bear Friends. Oh, no Hair Bear Friends. Oh, is that where we are? Yes, China. You see, I have to get my own program again, but this time with new friends.
Who is the new friend?
I believe it'll be the Bersons and Diggins and Gilbert,
right? Bersons? And what's it again?
Diggins and Gilbert.
Pinkus and Gilbert?
That is not Pinkus!
Well, I thought it was Pinkus.
Well, I remember that program.
Oh, well, so did I. And I know George used to watch that, didn't you?
Yeah, I sure did, Nova. And hello, China. How's No-Hare's doggy?
Fine, thanks. I'm just having it.
Oh, stop picking my name! Get off of me, mate! No-Hare, your dog is the best.
Why don't you talk about my pet dog,
big dog?
Okay. Both animals are blocking my face as well as my nose.
Oh, no!
Anyways, viewers, so whilst whilst those two keep sticking my face, now here's some shorts of Dingus and Gilbert. And get off of me!
Oh yeah! Oh, nope, that would work. Oh yeah, that's what I'm going for now.
Can you stop, Bill? You don't realize that I'm not a mirror, right?
Oh, you're right. I'm sorry.
And by the way, Bill, what's the occasion? Any reason for that attire?
I forgot what it was.
I'm so itchy. I can feel the itchiness in my feathers. Uh-huh. Oh, that feels so good.
You do realize that's Bill's dream, right?
Don't you realize how good it feels to scratch against some bark, Gilbert?
What are you doing down there?
Oh, Bill, I didn't see you. I was getting a good scratch.
On my tree.
Sorry, I forgot this was your tree.
All right, everybody, and that was Dingus and Gilbert, and I'm sorry about these two here. These two are nothing but trouble. Oh, they're almost as bad as each other. Aren't you two?
Yes. Yeah. Sorry, George. Sorry. That's all right.
See, that's the reason why we're talking about pets anyway, because it's all about pet animals.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Now, that's why I brought my pet dog with me.
Oh, well, okay. Understandable. Yeah, apart from being licked. You two are both dirty boys! Ah, you two are almost as bad as each other.
Oh! All right, Mr. Bear. Well, I believe you three. Now, see, this is your own show. Goodbye. Oh, thanks, Jonah. Well, I just said a high ball of it. High ball. Bye-bye, Jonah. Bye-bye. Yeah, bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Bye.
Well, George, isn't it great to see China again?
Yeah, of course it is great to see China again. Yeah, pop the beat licked.
What are you going to do about that?
Would it be this?
Get off me!
All right, now, Derby. Now, and I think we're going to have another guest though, to be coming on to No-Hare Bear and Friends.
Oh, yeah. Like what?
Like cat, dog.
Oh, well, okay. Well, I better leave you to it in case I get licked. See you later, everybody. See ya.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here comes cat, dog. All right, you two, come over here.
I see, but they're back. And I wonder if it's Pilgrim it is.
Yes, dog.
It's Pilgrim, is it? Is it SpongeBob SquarePants?
It's not SpongeBob SquarePants! Cut it out, dog.
Sorry.
Is it the Simpsons?
It's not the Simpsons!
Why do I have to bother watching it?
Dog, I believe what George is saying, that he said it's a new program of No-Hare Bear and Friends.
Oh! No-Hare Boom? No-Hare Bear and Friends? Well, where did you say so, George Peterson?
Well, I was trying to make you guess, but you keep getting the names wrong.
Sorry.
Anyway, George, why are you thinking No-Hare Bear and Friends?
Because...
You see, dog, because No-Hare Bear wants to be back on it for quite a long time since his own show Andrew the Heather.
Well, especially if it's George Beast the No-Hare.
Dog, don't you start with that again. And it is not George Beast.
All right, I knew that. But I also heard that you included the Bear Suits as well.
Why? Because the Bear Suits are like the Simpsons.
Oh, really? I see. Well, I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah, neither do I. Oh, hello, Rod.
Oh, hello, Cat. Good to see you again. Oh, how's your dog?
Oh, it went very well, thank you for asking. Yeah, and I'm very sorry about my brother dog here. He's been stupid as usual.
Yeah, tell me about it, Cat. Dog is always stupid, and I know you're the smartest one around here.
Yeah, I guess. So, anyways, Rod, is there a person short that starring me at dog?
Yes, I think there is one. And I think it was called Border Band Wants a Pet.
Oh. Border Band Wants a Pet, eh?
But Border Band Wants a Pet.
A dog, it's pets.
Well, I thought it was pests.
No, pets.
Pests.
Pets.
Pets.
Trouble.
Dog! What do you think you're playing at?
Dirty dog.
Sorry, George.
Oh, that's alright, dog. Anyway, that reason why I said pets, I didn't mean pests.
Alright, I understand that now. I think we'll both watch it.
Oh, yeah, good idea.
Alright then, well, here we go with the Bears and Short, and something to do with these two here. as Bort and Ben wanting to get a pet out of their own. Here we go with that.
Hey, you two, what's all this fighting about?
We were fighting about which one of us is going to have a cat or a dog.
Oh, really? Are you? Oh, well, go ahead then.
Well, I think you want a dog.
Well, you want a cat.
You want a dog.
Right, you two, stop fighting. And if I see any more fighting from you two, you do not get to watch cartoons, Bort, and you don't get to see Lisa Simpson at all.
But, Dad.
Yeah, Dad. Not one word.
I think you stink.
You drive me crazy.
Oi, that's what I said. Knock it off.
We didn't say anything, Dad.
Not one word.
Well, don't use whispering words either. So if you two want a pet cat or a dog, you two need to behave yourself.
Alright, Dad.
Alright, Dad.
Well, Captain Wack is a double.
What did you say, Bort?
Nothing.
Oh, good. All right, then, you two. I'm going to go down to the pet shop now, and I will get you two a pet cat or a dog.
All right, Dad.
Okay, Dad.
All right, and I won't be long. Well, see in a minute, first, we'll have to go and get those two a pet cat or a dog. See ya. Yay.
Ooh, Ben, I'm looking forward to getting a dog.
And I'm looking forward to getting a cat. I wonder which pet that dog will pick.
Well, you'll have to wait and see, Ben. We'll wait and see.
All right.
A few minutes later.
All right, you two. Yeah, I'm back from the pet shop.
Oh, okay, Dad. What pet did you get me?
And me? Well, first of all, you two. You two got now got yourself a pet. Dog.
Yay!
Yay! Oh, mine's a cat!
And mine's a dog! Thanks, Dad!
Oh, you're very welcome, you two. Right, I shall leave you to it, then. Well, bye-bye, everyone. See you in a minute. Yay!
Ooh, oh, let's have a look at dog. Oh, what a lovely doggy!
And what a lovely cat! Ooh, I'll just pet it. He's purring.
And I wonder if I could tickle behind dog's ear.
Do you know something? This dog reminds me of Santa's little helper, which I've never heard about. I wonder what name shall I give him this time? Well, it won't be Santa's little helper or anything.
I think he should be called...
Dumbo the Wacky! That's after my cat.
I had that, Bort!
Sorry, Dad.
Well, I'm going to call you Dumbo from now. Would you like that? Would you like that? Would you like that? Woof, woof, woof.
I'll just take that as a yes, then. Woohoo. And what pet are you going to name your cat up, then?
Well, I'm going to name mine... I'm going to name him... Benjamin.
Oh, good name.
Oh, Benjamin. You're a cute cat, you are. Yeah, you're so cute.
Meow.
Alright then, well, I suppose I better take my pet cat with me.
And I suppose I'd better take the pet dog with me. Well, see you in a minute, viewers.
Alright then, I suppose I'll take this pet dog home.
And I'll take the pet cat dog home.
Yeah, alright, let's go. I think this could mean one thing. I'm afraid we've now got stuck with a two-part animal. Uh-oh. Keep your paws off of my dog.
Well, keep your claws off my cat. Well, I'm going to take this pet cat home.
Well, I'm going to take this pet dog home. Right, come on then, let's go.
Oh, 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 oh.
Oh, what person? Are you trying to take my pet?
Well, are you trying to take my pet, dog?
Well, who needs a stupid big bro like you?
Well, who needs a stupid little brother of you?
Who needs a stupid boy?
Who needs a stupid one?
Who needs one? You're a stupid fat boy. What?
I am not a fat boy. Right, let's fight them.
Oh, yeah, bring it on, Tubby.
Tubby? Oh, he calls me a Tubby.
Ow! Ow, ow! 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 Oh, God, he's so big.
Oh, all right, then. All right, your father's here. Oh, all right, everybody. Hey, what up is going on?
Oh.
Not.
What you are? Help me,
Dad. Help. Hey, Bort, get off. Bort.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh, sorry, Dad. Well, you see, he was trying to take my pet dog.
But he
was
trying to take my pet cat.
Well, he's trying to take my pet dog. Oh. Well, thank you, two. Are you behaving badly?
Because I only wanted my pet.
Oh, see? Now you've just made your little bro upset. What were you thinking?
But I only wanted a pet dog.
Oh,
you know what, Dad? Oh, I didn't realise it was a two-part animal. This pet is a pet dog.
I'll stop moaning. Only because I had to pick it for you.
What? You are grateful, dipstick. Oh!
Bort, get off me! Get off me! Get off my friend!
Well, are you going to promise us that you'll get a proper cat and a dog?
Then go and get back to the shop and take the pet cat dog back! Alright, John. Alright. But first, you, but as for the time being, you're grounded!
What? Why am I grounded?
Because you've been a bit upset. Yeah, you're damn right it is, uh-oh. But I will strangle you again if you don't go to your room.
Alright, I'm going.
Well, see you in a minute, Very sorry about Bort, everybody. Yeah, it looks like he's the one who's behaved badly. Well, I'd better go and have a check. Oh, I didn't realise that this was a two-part animal. Oh dear. Never mind, Fuse. Well, I'd better comfort Ben now. Well, I'm just going to help him anyway. But first, I'll get Barbara to have a hug on Ben here. Hey, Barbara, hey, come and sort your son out. I'm afraid he's injured because Bort's hurt him.
Oh no! Wait, don't worry, Wacky. I'm coming. Oh, hello there. What's going on, Wacky?
Ah, well, because you say, Barbara, I'm afraid that Bort and Ben had a big fight over this two-part animal.
Oh, is that the reason why?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. But I'm afraid Ben, however, is crying because I think he needs you. He needs you now.
Oh dear. So, are you taking this pet cat dog back?
Yes, afraid so, because I don't think these two-part animals aren't going to help.
Oh, all right. Well, you do that then, and I'll look after Ben.
Oh, don't worry about Bort, though. I already told him that he's grounded.
Oh, good for you. Don't be too long now, my darling.
Okay. Well, share a minute, Fuse, for while I take this rip-off pet dog back. All right, you two. Sorry, but you're going back to the pet shop.
No.
Well, bye-bye, Fuse. See you when we get back. Goodbye.
All right, Ben. Are you all right?
No, Mum, I'm not okay. I'm afraid Bort has hurt my face. Look.
Wolf, did Bort hurt you?
Yeah, he did. Oh, I don't like Bort anymore.
Oh, it's all right, Bort. It's all right, Ben. I don't need to cry. It's all right. there, my darling. Be a brave boy.
But, Mum, I'm not brave anymore. I think Maud hates me. It's because we only ended up in a big fight.
Oh, it's all right, but, well, you two really shouldn't have a fight over a pet cat or a dog. Should you?
Well, only because Bot started off with the fight, but it wasn't me. What? And now, Bot's Bot is grounded, and I'll never see my pet cat again.
Oh, don't worry, Bot. Oh, don't worry. Your father will get you a pet cat, and as for Bot, a new pet dog. It's okay, my darling. There. Be brave. Be brave, my dear. Tell you what, I'll take you straight to your room, so you could just have your feet and a hug on me more.
Okay, Mummy.
Well, see you a bit first whilst I take him. See ya.
Oh, it's alright, Bort. Don't worry. We're in your room now, so you're okay. It's alright, my darling. There's no need to cry. Oh, it's okay. Don't worry. Your dad will be back with a proper cat, and as for Bort, a proper dog.
Okay, Mummy. Well, I told you, but I'm not going to see my good cat again.
Oh, it's all right, Bort. I mean, Ben, it's okay. No need to cry. I'm sure your dad will be back.
Oh, I hope so, Mummy.
Hey, you two, I'm back, and I got a surprise for Ben first.
Woo! Did you hear that, Ben? Your father's got a surprise for you.
Really? What is it?
Well, you'll have to see your father, though.
Okay, Mummy. I won't, Daddy. Ready when you are.
Oh, all right, then, son. Now, don't cry. I've got something special for you. Right, here we are, Ben. This is your own pet cat now. Oh, and what name are you going to give?
Well, the last thing I remember is that I'm afraid what it was, Benjamin.
Well, I think you'll name this one Snowbell.
Ah, oh, that's even better. Oh, thank you, Daddy. I love you.
Oh, yeah, well, I love you too, son. Yeah, see, I thought about you, and I would never ever tear you off. No, of course not. You're my best boy in the world. Yeah, of course you are. I mean, after all, who's a brave boy? Who's a bastard?
Get off me, Frankie Boy! Thanks, Dad, and I promise you, I'll never get tired of my pet cat again.
Ah, good. Right, why don't you go play with your cat then? And of course, I'll deal with your little bro, big bro.
Thanks, Dad. Oh, come on then. Come on then, Benjamin. Let's go. Bye-bye, everyone. See you in the next short. Bye. Meow.
All right, Barbara. Right, I thought he just gave him a pet cat now. Oh, and, it's what... I already told him and he's grounded. And I already got him something too. But he has to earn his pet dog if he wants to behave and say shy to him.
Oh, but didn't you tell him that you grounded him?
Oh. Hey, what then, Barbara? I think we'll just deal with him probably in the next part of his short or so.
All right then, Wacky. Your choice.
All right. Well, bye-bye then, Furious. Well, see you in the next part in the short, everybody. See you later. Yay.
And bye-bye for me, Barbara.
And that was one of the best in short, however. Yeah, it looks like that board is now grounded for trying to take the pet cat dog away. Well, it looks like that in the next special short, which will happen later, which board has to say sorry to Ben. Yeah, just like Bart did with Lisa on Thanksgiving. In an episode of it, of course. Well, you two, were you two alright in that short?
I didn't think so.
Well, I think I'm alright.
Ah, well, I'm glad you're alright, dog. I mean, cat, sorry. That's right. Oh, and as for you, dog, don't worry about those two. Well, they were only just fighting over a pet.
But thank you. I wouldn't fight over dogs that try to take my garbage.
Yeah. And if you mean garbage trucks, At least you won't fight with them then.
No. So can I at least see the bear then?
Oh, are you sure, dog?
Yeah, of course I'm sure. I mean, besides, I think you might have used me in the shirt, didn't you?
Yeah, I suppose I did, dog. I suppose I did. Alright, go and see them.
Alright, well, see you later, buddy.
Yeah, see you later, buddy. Oh.
Okay, so let's hand over to the bear suits now. But first, it's time for one more Dingus and Gilbert short. And here it is first.
So, Dingus, what do you do in your spare time?
I usually read the newspaper. I usually read the comic strips, since it's the only part of the paper I care about.
And why is that?
I'm gonna show you right now.
Wait, you're not. Where am I?
You're in one of the comic strips. I'm gonna give you a really big anvil.
Ow. Why are you doing this? I never did anything wrong, Dingus.
I can and I will. That's why.
I'll be able to come out of here if you apologize.
Let me think for a second. Why not? I'm sorry I had to do this.
And that reminds me, why do you like comics?
Well, they're amusing and entertaining. And that's all I can say about that.
I understand.
And that was one of the Dingus and Gilbert shorts. Oh, and I'm sorry we only had to do one more short, because I've chosen comic humor. Yeah, because it looks like Dog was the one that does the comic humor the most, because he always says stupid things. But anyways, let's go over to the Bearsons now.
Hello, everybody. Andy Bearson here, and I'm here with my family. Barbara, Bort, and Bear. Say hello, you three.
Hello, everybody.
Hello, everyone. Ben Bearson here. Ben the Bear. Ben the Bear. He's the stupidest bear in town. What? Sorry, Dad. Sorry, Ben. That's all right. You didn't mean to say, and how dare you say the wrong words. I'm just joking, Ben. Oh. So, Dad?
Yes, sir?
I heard that in this program of No-Hare Bear and Friends, are they talking about pets?
Yes, sir. Of course. Now, do you remember back then when you and Ben used to have a fight over a pet cat or a dog?
Yes. I think I remember now.
Oh, yeah. It's just because I don't think the pet cat dog thing is working out well.
That was when Ben was little back then, as well as I was.
Yeah, that's right, Sean. Because you had to say sorry to Ben.
Yeah, I know, Dad. But I'm glad that's over and done.
Yeah.
Well, no. Here we go with one of our special guests to come and see the persons. Here's Kurt Dog. Kurt Dog. Kurt Dog.
Oh!
Oh. Hello, everybody. Well, I'm back again. Oh, hey, Mike. Well, I believe you're in the person's universe, because that means you get to see them again.
Oh, I see. Oh, hello, family.
Oh, hello, dog.
Oh, hello, dog.
Hey, why are you saying hello, dog, in an angry way?
Well, you see, because I didn't know, but me and Ben didn't know, because you two were a two-part animal.
Yeah, that's right. That's what we are, see?
Oh, yeah. Well, now I finally understood after 2 years. Oh, what about you, Ben?
I don't know. Let's have a look at them.
Oh, yeah, I remember now. Yeah, that was different back then. Oh, dear. And I'll join you this time, big bro.
Oh, dear. Well, better send for me the champion.
Hey, what did you say, Andy?
I said, better send for the Lee Ambulance.
Lee Ambulance? Who is that Lisa anyway? Well, is it Lisa Simpoo?
It is not Lisa Simpoo.
Yeah, but I don't like Lisa Simpoo. As I heard, she's one of the stupidest girls. And also, she's too smart and she's been a brat.
She is not a brat.
Yeah, well, I think she is.
Oh, no, she's not.
Oh, yes, she is.
No, she's not.
Yes, she is.
No, she isn't.
No, she's not.
Oh, yes. Oh,
yeah, you and the Andy Pandy. It smells of a stinky old trap.
What? No, a stinky old trap. How dare you, dog?
Sorry, Annie. But I reckon that you could be like Sheldon.
Shelton? What are you on about, dog?
I was just saying that you look like Shelton J. Planter.
Oh, I'm not Shelton J. Planter.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah, I'm very sorry about that dog, though. He's not usually like this.
That's okay.
Yeah, well, I suppose that dog is a bit stupid sometimes, isn't he?
Yeah, I suppose he is. Oh, and why are those two son of yours great?
It's because they remembered about their past for when you and Mortimer used to fight over you and Dog.
Oh, yeah. Well, don't you worry, Andy. Dog has already shown that to Mortimer already. How are you, Dog?
Yeah, could be. Ew, and I think that they fainted.
Yeah, that's right, Dog. I'm afraid so, Andy.
Oh, dear. Now, as I said, best is said for the least ambulance.
Oh, very amusing, Andy.
Oh, you think so?
Nope. You're wasting 5 pence for that.
Never mind. Dieters?
Yes?
Can you get Lisa at Maggie for us?
Oh, yeah, with pleasure, Andy. But first, I'd better get you stand up again.
All right.
All right, Lisa. Well, you're on air again.
Oh, all right, come here. Oh, hello, Andy.
Oh, hello, Lisa. You never guess what happened that day.
No?
I'm afraid that a water bed down there has fainted.
Whoa! Why?
Well, you see, Lace, come and sit on my lap for a minute. So you see, Lace, that the reason why water bed has fainted is because they remembered their own past.
Oh, it's a bug cat dog.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, you might as well help Ben up now. Don't bother helping.
All right, I'll get Bobber to help board anyway. All right, Bobber, can you help board out now? All right, Lisa. I'll head up my way. Hello. Are you okay, Benny? Benny. Happy dog.
Hi, all right, I am up. Oh, hello, Lisa, the cheeky monkey.
Woo! You call me cheeky monkey. I'm going to kick you!
Oh no! No, there's a smell! They said, I'm
doing! Ow! That was like a nice. Ow.
What did you do that for? Cheeky monkey. Well, you're a cheeky monkey!
No, you're a cat. You too. Stop arguing.
Sorry, Auntie.
Sorry, Dad. That's alright. Anyways, Ben, are you okay, son? I'm all right, Dad. Hey, sorry if me and Bort had a fate. Yeah, because we remembered our past. Ah, don't you worry about the past, Ben. We're in the future now. Oh, yeah, I suppose so.
At least my future wife is Lisa. Isn't that right, my lovely?
Yeah, that's right, Benny. It is. You're my future husband.
And you're my future wife. That's good, then.
Oh, that's adorable, Auntie.
Yeah, I know, Barbara. Yeah, they are adorable together. I don't think the narrator likes it. What do you think, Joby?
I am not Joby. Oh, no. Not a kissing. Oh, gross.
Get over it, Dieter.
But
get over it, or you'll grab.
Oh, you can't grab the narrator like that, you big goat.
Oh! Directors, what are you doing? See you after the break, everybody. Don't go away.
Oi, and that's George Beeston's life.
Ow!
End of part one. Welcome back to the second part of this show. Let's see for where they left off.
Hello, Benny. How are you?
Feels good, I guess.
Oh, Benny.
Oh, well, I'm glad she still loves me as of today.
Yeah, I can't believe that she still kept kicking me with her high foot.
What was happening?
Nothing. I was just saying clipboard shoes.
That's better, Penny.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Right, I better put you down first.
So, Penny, so I thought that you booty boy had a bit of trouble with the pet dog and cat. Why?
I can't tell you that.
Why? Please tell me, Penny. I want the
tickles. Oi, get off of me, Jen. All right, I'll tell you. The reason why me and Bud have fainted, because I think cat dog is probably the worst pet, because it's like a two-part animal.
Oh, I see. See, you should have told me that before.
Yeah, I know. So anyway, Steve, I think we got cat dog here with us today.
Well, okay, Penny. Well, I better join you. Barbara, can you do help Paul? Alright. Are you alright then, Paul?
I'm alright, Mum. Yeah, thank you for helping me. Sorry if you had seen me and Ben faint.
That's okay, because you were very naughty back then. But what were you?
Naughty?
Well, you were, but I'm glad you changed.
Yeah, I guess so, Mum.
Alright, Andy. Yeah, I think the kissy bit is over.
Ah, well, thank goodness for that.
Yeah, I agree. Alright then. Now, whilst Ben and Lisa, Ben and Bob were fainted for a while, here's Cat Dog again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back. Oh, hello, Beth and Emily.
Oh, hello, Cat Dog. Oh, hello, everybody. Oh, hello, Cat. We haven't forgot about you. Oh, okay.
Oh, hello, Beth and Emily. Oh, hello, Lisa and Boo.
What? Dog, cut it up, you.
Ouch. Oh, sorry.
That's all right, dog. Just don't call me that again.
I won't. So anyway, Peter, I heard that you are married to Ben the Spaghetti Hoops.
He is not a Spaghetti Hoops. Are you, Benny?
No, I'm not, Liz. How dare you call me the Spaghetti Hoops?
Sorry. So anyways, I also heard that you got your own show with you.
Well, what you see at that dog, because as after the success of 10 series and a few specials along the way, George have decided to give me my own show.
Oh, good for you, Ben.
Oh, yeah, I agree with Dog, yeah. Yeah, good of you to have your own show with your little lady, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Oh, you haven't seen Maggie, have you?
No.
But I certainly haven't.
Well, can you show us, huh?
Yeah, sure. Hey, Baggy, come here, baby girl.
Oh, hello, Maggie. Well, now, how's my favourite baby girl?
Baggy boy, Big Ben.
Uh-oh. Achoo!
Gross! Ben Carson, that is disgusting. Oh, bless you, though.
Thanks, Dodgers. Well, Maggie, you never guess what we got today. I believe that we got Cat Dog with her.
Cat Poo? Cat Poo?
Maggie, it is not Cat Poo.
Sorry, Ben.
That's alright. And I believe you meant Cat Dog.
Yeah. Sorry, Pepe.
Oh, that's alright, Maggie. You didn't mean to say cat poo. Yeah, it's just a bit of a pronounced trouble for her, as well as the other people are. Alright, I'll show you. Give me that baby girl. Alright, you two, introduce yourselves to Maggie.
Oh, alright. We're both grubby.
Oh, hello again. Ooh, who's that little cutie, Papa?
I believe that's Maggie from The Simpsons.
Oh, hello, Maggie. Aw, how are you, sweetie?
Bye-bye.
Oh, she gave me a nick.
Oi, where on earth did the dog go?
Here I am. Dog! Sorry, Barbara Ann.
Get off me! I don't think I'll be that
pet! Out!
Hey, what did you do that for, Barbara Ann? And what did you call me Barbara Ann for? I'm not Barbara Ann.
Yeah, but that's your name, isn't it?
No, it's not.
Oh, yes it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Oh, Todd.
Got it. Andy?
Yes, Barbara?
Guess what they'll call me?
No.
He called me Barbara Ann! Barbara Ann!
Oh, no. Not the chicks!
No! Oh, boy, safety, sir. Tell me about it, Barbara. Boys, but I love my Benny. Oh, I expect your opinion. Sorry, Auntie, but I don't like it when you laugh at me.
That's all right, Barbara. And I suppose that's my fault for laughing.
I know that, Auntie. A dog?
Yeah?
That's called me Barbara Ann again.
I won't.
How about Bobby Pat? No! I'm not Bobby Pat!
Alright, I forget. No Bobby Pants either.
Yeah, that's fine. No Bobby Pants and no Barbara Ann!
Alright, I knew that. Now, that's not the same, Maggie. Yeah, sorry about that.
That's okay. Doggy, doggy.
Oh, she loves me.
Doggy, doggy, doggy.
Tickle in the ear. Oi. Oh, what's Maggie on about? Oi, get off of me. Oh, I like this.
Pet doggy.
Yeah, that's my doggy. Dog is a pet doggy.
Doggy, doggy, doggy. This one. That's Maggie from Santa's Little Helper. Doggy, show cat.
Oh, all right then.
Oh, hello there. Oh, hello, little girl. How are you?
Hi, thank you. Big nose.
Well, I didn't know that cat was being hugged by nose on Maggie here. Oh, good job, Maggie. Zombie nose. Zombie nose pizza!
Oh, my nose! That was like your nose. Ow.
Oh, what's Maggie got done that for?
Yes. What's Maggie got done that for?
Because she thinks you look like Krusty the Clown.
I do not sound like him.
Well, I think Dog could be one.
Oh, I see. My nose. Oh, stop moaning about your nose. It's fine. God. All right, Maggie. Don't call me that.
Sorry.
That's all right.
Hi, Maggie, get off your cat's whiskers!
Oh, no one!
Sorry, Ben.
Oh, alright, Maggie. What did you do to cat?
Pulled by a whisker.
Oh.
Sorry?
Oh no, Maggie. Oh, I'm sorry. At least I hadn't yelled at you this time. At least I didn't. But it's my fault anyway. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, it's alright. Shh. Don't cry, Maggie. Don't cry. Ben's here. I'm sorry if I had to stop you there. Don't you worry, Mags. It isn't your fault. You're a bad girl. No, of course you're not. You're lovely. Oh.
I love you!
As well as you do to Barry, of course.
Yeah, but you love me as well. Yeah, of course. Of course, of course, of course.
Maggie, sorry for crying, Ben's belly.
Oh, that's all right. Yeah, well, I'm glad you're all right.
Now, look at me, Maggie. It's not okay for you to play around with the whiskers or the nose, because you could have pulled their whiskers off. You should know that.
Oh dear, looks like Maggie's fainted on me. That's all right. Well, I'd better take her straight off to bed then. Yeah, before she has any more bad past about dog. Oh, and mind you, I don't think that she usually does that to Sanderson help or Snowball too, for that matter. Come on, Maggie, let's get you into bed.
Yay. Bye-bye.
Yeah, and Maggie say bye-bye. Right, come on, Maggie, let's get you into bed then. Right, it's alright, everybody. Now, don't worry about Maggie. She's in bed now. Hey, sorry about Maggie, though. Yeah, I think she likes cat dog anyway. But I think she prefers it if Snowball's too, or Santa's doesn't help but to come with her as well. Alright, you two. I'm very sorry about Maggie. Well, she's usually like that when it comes to cat and dogs.
Yeah, that's alright.
Yeah, that's alright. Oh, look what Maggie's done to my nose, though. She hogged my nose.
Oh, I see. Well, don't you worry, Aunt Cat. Maggie's in bed now, so she can't plonk your nose anymore. Never mind pulling your whiskers.
Yeah, well, that's all right. At least I won't have to put up with her.
Anyway. But I think Maggie loves me as a cute little doggy.
Oh, do you think so, dog?
Yeah, indeed. Anyways, well, I better leave you and the rest of your family to it then.
Okay, then.
See if I can do it speaks to this one.
It's Buxton, you stupid dog.
Oh, sorry, I meant Buxton.
Ah, that's better.
Now, as I'm saying, see when I get back to George Buxton. See you soon.
Yeah, see you when we get back. Goodbye.
Yeah, bye.
Well, that was very great to see Cat Dog as well. Well then, but now, do you remember Cat Dog? Have I missed it? Well, you might have missed it though. Yeah, it's just because so I just stop you from worrying about our past. Ah, well, at least I don't have to put up with that Cat Dog, because that Cat Dog is stupid and I hate them.
What?
Yes, Mum.
Why would you be so nasty to Cat and Dog?
Well, you see, Mum, now, do you remember what happened?
Yeah, I remember what happened last time.
Well, because Cat Dog is a rip-off! You two, come here!
Oh, no. Oh, what did he mean before? All right.
Oh,
again, everybody. Yes?
Never mind yes, Dog! Why were you being a two-part animal for?
But that's because we're stuck together. Look.
But I don't care, Dog. Either separate yourselves from Cat, or I shall ground you like my dad does to me.
I don't think that's going to happen, but I don't get to growl at you if you carry on like this.
Hell yeah. Show me your growl then, Tubby. Tubby! Oh no, I think I made him growl.
Nobody calls me a Tubby.
Alright then, Dog, it's revenge for you!
Yeah, bring it on!
Tubby Raccoon! Tubby Raccoon! I am not a Tubby Raccoon! Right, let's bring it on!
Yeah, let's do it! Yeah, bad bite you, Bob Bessie. You stink. Sorry, everybody. But I had to do that, though. Yeah, because I don't think that Bob likes me.
You know what? I don't think I like Bob either. It's nothing but a stinky old chicken nugget.
I heard that.
Anyways, up yours. Well, I think I better leave again. See you when I get back to George Beaton. Bye-bye.
All right, everybody. Sorry about my son. Well, he's not usually like that. Oh, dear. Are you all
right, Dandy. Sorry if I had to kick you earlier.
Oh! I'm all right, Barbara. So what was all that noise about? It's not for you, is it?
Oh, it's not for me, Andy. It's not for Ben, and it's not for Lisa, and definitely not for Maggie. I'm afraid it's something to do with Bort.
So what did Bort do wrong?
Well, I'm afraid that Bort and the cat dog had a fight with each other as well as the bear he did with Bear.
What? Is that true, Barbara?
Yeah, I'm afraid so, Andy. You might want to deal with it during the epilogue.
Okay. Well, I suppose I will do that in the epilogue also. After this programme ends.
Yeah, so you're right, Andy. After the end of the programme.
Good. Anyways, I think we'll sort Bort out later. Yeah, and I saw that he just fell down easily. Why?
It's because the dog had a fight with the board.
Oh, I see. Anyways, let's say goodbye now, eh?
Yeah, all right, Andy. Bye, me first. Bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Bye-bye.
And bye-bye for me, Ben Bearson. Come on, Lisa. Let's go.
Okay, Benny. See you soon, everybody. Bye-bye.
And I will see you in the epilogue after the programme. And when I get to sort out Bort Bearson. See you later, everybody. See ya. Oh, and don't forget to look out for us extra short for when Bort says sorry to Ben. See you later.
And that was the Bearsons meet cat dog.
Oh, yeah. Well, I didn't even know that that cat dog was a bit angry with Bort.
Oh, yeah, that was after being stretched in the past. Oh, yeah, and it's a good thing we already had that short earlier on. Well, no, but, well, what do you think of cat dog, then?
Well, it was very good. Oh, yeah, plus I get to meet kind of a dog as well. At least he's friendlier than a dog.
Yeah, tell me about it. And he's less stupid as well.
Well, apart from being licked in the face from earlier. What? You mean like this? No, don't!
Yes, Derby. Just like that.
Dirty boy. Sorry.
Now, anyways, viewers, now, as promised, here we go with another Bearson short. And this time, Bort gets to say sorry to Ben. Enjoy.
Oh, hello again, everybody. Welcome back to the short. Well, viewers, you never guess what I did wrong. Well, first of all, I've had a fight with Ben, and I've made a minor put his head a bit. And I can't believe my father grounds me. And I'll never get my pet dog. And he was my best friend.
Hey, Bort. Bort.
What do you want? Go away.
Fine, if you say so.
No, Dad. It's okay. Come back. I promise I won't be naughty again.
All right then, Bort. Well, I hope you've learned your lesson now. So, why did you have a fight with Ben anyway?
Well, I only wanted was a pet dog, Dad. But unfortunately, I've hurt his head. Oh, because I know you're going to strangle me.
Well, I wouldn't strangle you.
Well, you would. Can I just call myself the son, eh?
Afraid so, Bort. And I know I did say that you're grounded, but I've got something special for you.
Really, Dad? What is it?
Well, if you go apologise to your little brother right now, I will give it to you then.
Well, okay, Dad. If I must. Now, come on, viewers. Let me go apologise to my little bro. Well, come with me, then.
Ah, what a lovely pet cat you are. Yeah, you're so fluffy. Tickle, tickle. Meow. Oh, cutie, cookie.
Hey, Ben, Ben.
What? Who said that?
It's me, your little bro. I think my dad's got wants me to say something to you.
Well, come here, Ben.
Okay. Oh, I was so scared.
Well, Ben? Well, Bort? Aren't you going to say something to me?
Well, I don't know. Well, I mean, not after what happened. Well,
I don't think so.
What? Why did you have a fight with me for?
Ah, well, you see, Ben, I only wanted a pet dog, and there you are, you've got a pet cat now. Well, looks like, I'm alone without a pet. Well, I'd better leave you to it then, Ben.
But, Bort, do you want to apologize to me?
No way!
Bort, say sorry!
All right. Okay. Right, so if I have to apologize to my brother, Ben, just because I only just had a fight, well... Uh-oh. I'm sorry, Ben, for ending up in a big fight.
Apology accepted.
Well, I'm so glad that Bort has finally apologized to his little brother. And me and Barbara are great parents. Well, I suppose I'd better reward him with a pet dog. Digest, can you pass me that pet dog?
Oh, yeah, with pleasure, Wacky. Hello?
Thank you very much. Alright then, Bort. Oh, and I see your little bro has given you a hug. Well, did you say sorry to him? Yes, Dad, I apologize to him now. Yeah, and I'm also very sorry if I did badly behave with a pet cat dog. Don't worry about what, it's all in the past now. But look, I got something for you, and that's for being a good boy who says sorry to his little bro. Here you are. Oh, and I think it'll be a hound.
Well, look at that. I got myself a pet dog! Whoop-de-dee, 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 whoop-de-dee. Whoop-de-dee!
Oh yeah, well I better get off the camera right away.
That's better.
Well, I'm going to try playing with him, and I'm going to name him, instead of Dumbo this time, I'm going to call him a proper one in fact. Whoopee! Rudolph the Black-Nosed Dog. Well then Rudolph, right, let's go play ball then. Ruff, 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 ruff. Well, bye-bye viewers. See you next time.
And see you next time for me, Ben Bearson.
And me, Father Wacky.
And me, Barbara the Mom.
And that was one of the Bearson shorts. And I'm glad that Bort has said sorry to Ben already. Well, Derby, well, what do you think of that short?
Well, I say that's a bit like based off an episode, which is called Bort vs. Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's the same thing, isn't it?
Yeah, but except with the pets.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and I'm also glad that Bort has now got a pet dog called Rudolph.
Rudolph? What?
No, Herr. That was just the name of the Bearson's show. Not in this program, you don't.
Phew. I thought so. So, anyways, George, what are we going to be doing now? I mean, we've only just done one Gilbert Dingers and Gilbert shot earlier.
Well, Derby, we could revisit your old programme.
What? Can we?
Yeah, of course we can.
Oh, that'd be cosmic. Which one are we going to be having?
We're going to do about Burger King.
Ah, Burger King? George?
Yes, Cat Derby?
One thing before you start that old episode of mine. Which dog food does he like best? Which dog likes best?
Well, I think he likes dog food, but the best thing that dogs like
George, I have another one question.
What's that then?
Is your face smell of great big... Does your smell of great big pints of meat?
My face! Smell of great big pints of meat? How dare you! My face does not smell of that. Cut it out, Mr. Bear.
Ow!
Well, here's No-Hare Bear's old episodes anyway. Just to refill it, and also to finish off this episode. Edge.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Now, I'm glad to be back in the 8th episode. Now, today, however, George Buxton is taking me out to Burger King.
Yep, because you see, viewers, I haven't been to Burger King before for a long time.
Yeah, because that was from Daughter of No-Hare Bear, TV special number 28 ago, from when I first came along. And this time, Daughter's going to take me again. Woohoo! Right, and this time, my own shot. So, let's go and see George Buxton now. George, are you going to take me to Burger King? You know, just like we did last time.
Huh? What's all this talk about the Burger King trip? No-Hare Bear, is that you? Could you come over here, please?
Oh, okay, George, I'm coming. Hello, George.
Oh, hello, No-Hare Bear.
So, where are we going to today? Is it Subway again? Oh, because I hate salad from last time.
No, No-Hare Bear. Well, this time, I'm taking you out to Burger King this time, because you haven't been to Burger King for a while.
Yay! Burger King? Oh, Burger King is much nicer than Subway. I'm so excited. I could jump on George's head again, just like I did last time.
Oh, no. Hey, you can't jump my head. Oh, not this again. No-Hare Bear.
Oh, sorry, George. I'm a bit excited. Right, I'm going to do the timber. And also to say Merry Christmas. Here we go. Merry Christmas! Sorry about that, George. I had to do that, yeah, because I'm too excited.
I know you're excited, Little Bear. Oh, and I already did told you that if you can't get out of my mouth, I'll be no Burger King trip, and that means you'll be sticking to salad.
No, George, please, I don't want to stick to salad. I want to go to Burger King, please.
Alright, yeah, but this is just a one-off trip.
Oh, alright, well, see you in Burger King, everybody. See you later.
Yeah. Well, I suppose I better get going as well. So I'll see you in Burger King, everybody. See you later. By the time George took No-Hare Bear to Burger King for his lunch after all this time. Memories, memories.
Okay then, No-Hare Bear. Right, we're at Burger King again, so come up now.
Oh, okay, I'm coming. Hello, everybody. Do you know which restaurant are we in?
Do you recognise the place from George and No-Hare Bear TV special number 28?
Yeah.
Well, this time, we're at Burger King, and it's your new own show.
Oh, that is very exciting. Can I have a drink first?
Sure thing. If you think so, yeah, that's fine.
Right, I'm going to do the same thing as I did from last time at Subway, on my own. Right, can I drink?
Sure, enjoy.
Wow, that was delicious. Thank you, George. Now, can you show me what you got as a meal?
Sure thing.
Oh, all right then. Oh, George, what's that?
Oh, that's a burger. Do you remember that?
Oh, no.
Oh, don't worry, but this is the first time you've ever had a burger.
Ooh, that is very exciting. But what sort?
Oh, that's long pepperoni.
Aye? Long pepperoni? Long pepperoni? Oh, I never heard of it. Is it going to be good?
Yeah, of course it will be good. I promise.
Oh, all right then. Right, I'm going to enjoy this. Even if it kills me.
Try those nuggets.
Sure. Yeah, sit a minute, please.
Okay, No-Hare Bear, the nuggets are ready now, so you can come up now.
Oh, okay. Are these nuggets? Oh, I remember these from when the last time I came here. Is it still going to be good?
Yeah, of course it will be good, No-Hare Bear.
I promise. Oh, all right. Right, looking forward to this one. River Road, everybody. Oh, are we going to have an ice cream later?
Maybe. We'll think about it.
Oh, all right then. Well, sit a bit, Fields.
By the time No-Hare Bear had his lunch at Burger King, they are heading to Nine Streets to have a little surprise for him. What is...
Okay, then, No-Hare Bear. Right, here we are. We're at outside Nine Streets Country Park, so you can come up now.
Okay. Hello. Why are we at Nice Prince Country Bar?
Well, I just thought you might like to show you an ice cream.
Oh, alright. Oh, what sort of ice cream is this one?
That's Oreo. Would you like to try it?
Yeah, please.
Right, I'm looking forward to this.
Huh? Wow, this ice cream's delicious. Thank you, George.
Oh, you're welcome, Noah. Now, shall we go back to our room now?
Yeah, please. Oh, alright then. Well, see you later, viewers, for when we go back to the bedroom. Bye.
By the time No-Hare Bear had his ice cream, George took him back to Rubber Road for a well-earned rest. That was delicious.
Well, we're back from Burger King, everybody. And boy, that was a good meal for No-Hare Bear, because he hasn't been for a while, and now he has. Hey, No-Hare Bear, come over here, please.
Oh, okay, I'm coming.
Did you enjoy your Burger King meal today?
Yeah, George. Oh, and as for the burger, George, well, that was the first time I've ever had a burger. So, yee-haw! Yeah, I like that burger. Oh, thank you, George, for choosing that one.
Oh, you're welcome. Oh, it was long pepperoni.
Oh, I remember. Yeah, that was very exciting for me. Woohoo. Yeah, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Anyway, would you like to say goodbye to viewers now?
No, please. Oh, alright then. Well, bye-bye then, viewers. Well, see you in the next episode then. Just until we get to the 10th episode. Bye-bye. Yeah.
And as for me, however, time for me to say goodbye as well. So, I would leave you with No-Hare Bear going out to Burger King. So I'll see you next time, viewers, and until then, bye-bye, everybody. See you again soon.
And that was one of No-Hare Bear's old episodes, which is the Burger King one, which me and No-Hare Bear have been before. Well, No-Hare Bear, does it bring you back any memories?
Yeah, of course it does bring back memories. Yep, and it's a good thing we've only done the Subway bit last time, haven't we?
Yep, we did, No-Hare Bear, back in episode one it was.
Yeah, of course it was. But I think Burger King is definitely the best.
Why do you think Burger King's the best in your opinion?
Because, George. Well, obviously, it's because of the big juicy meat. Except I've had a double burger and it's got pepperoni in it.
Yeah, that's right. That was part of the King Box.
So I wonder what the King Box is up to now.
Well, apparently they only do double melts now.
Oh, double melts? Why do they do that?
Because they were just trying to get them to be interested in King Box again.
And
plus, they even serve as onion rings and chili cheese bites. And there's fries and a drink.
That sounds delicious. But as for chili cheese bite, no, I wouldn't like it. But anyway, so that brings me back memories then.
Yeah. All right, now, Bet, you can go on and do what you want to do now.
Okay. Bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Bye.
And me and No-Hare Bear will be back in the next episode. So until then, bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.
Welcome to this epilogue, and I'm sorry if I had to take over after this program ends. Yeah, because I have to deal with the bot now, because I also heard that he's had a fight with Cat Dog. Yeah, that wasn't very nice though. And you, bot, come here for the instant, you man!
Oh, alright then, Dad. Come in. Yes, Dad?
What? Were you fighting with Cat Dog?
No.
What? Tell me the truth, boy. Otherwise, you're not going to be in the next episode of No-Hare Bear Friends.
Alright. Here's the truth. Now, the reason why me and the Cat Dog had a fight is because that I just thought if I just get revenge on Cat Dog, because, it was all about in the past though, Dad, so that's why I had to give revenge on Cat Dog. By giving them a fight that they will not soon forget. And that's the reason why I fight with them. Ferris said. See, I knew it. Well, what did get you got revenge on CatDog just because of the... I understand it's like a two-part animal, but you have to get used to it. Well, what if I don't, Dad? I don't want CatDog in that one anymore. And I also want you to go straight to your room. You're now grounded for 10 weeks this time. Oh, but Dad... Go to your room now!
Fine. Well, I suppose I'll have to then.
Yeah, bad bite you, you dead pandy. Ow!
Well, that's it. But next time, I'll get that revenge on CatDog. CatDog!
I'll judge him for this CatDog! Can't you?
Oh, gosh. Why does the bot have to be like that for a CatDog?
Oh, yeah, that's never happened in the best specials. Oh, dear. Anyway, Shapiros, now, because this is the epilogue, though, and I know it's been a long time since we've last done it, well, I'll finish it off after I've done the little announcement. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to apologise for what happened with Borat today, because he doesn't like CatDog anymore. Oh, and I'm also afraid to say that CatDog is Bort's number one enemy. Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen, though. So, will Bort get revenge on CatDog again? Well, you'll soon find out in the next episode of No-Hare Bear and Friends, which I pretty doubt. Well, see you next time, everybody. Bye-bye. Right, and you, Dad, Cameron. Back away, please.
Oi!
Oh! Hello there. Ooh. I also heard that Andy's already done that now.
Yeah, that's right, George. You must not knock off if you want to.
All right then, Dices. Get away from me. That's enough now.